The original name was, we swim the biggest lake in Britain, Lake Windermere, 10.5 miles long. And then we cycle from Lake Windermere south, 250 miles, and then do a full marathon back home. So I was like, phew, bloody hell. I've done Ironmans and stuff like that, but that's a challenge.
Time is 6:15. We're in a car park right next to Lake Windermere and I'm fucking shitting myself.
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Slept in there all night. Woke up at 4:30, had my pasta, coffee, bananas, had a shit, more importantly, because there's no way I'm shitting in my wetsuit. Never piss in it, make you nice and warm. Now we've got to go to the jetty.
Excited.
Time to dive in. Yeah, excited, nervous.
Right.
I suppose it's 2 years of training. Another big day's come.
I had a good night's sleep. I felt good, a little bit nervous, obviously. We got a load of breakfast done and that. Ready for the swim, we met up with Colin. He basically told us the do's and don'ts of swimming across the lake. We jumped on the boat. Well, he jumped on the boat along with Warren and Rob.
Right then, fucking tight to rock the roll.
First time we went into the water, it was cold, really cold.
Oh, got in there and it was fucking freezing.
That is off 16 degrees.
That's freezing.
That's minus 16.
Your face gonna numb soon, be fine.
Bags.
In my head, I said, right, you know, as soon as I get going and everything, I'll be right, I'll warm up. Whew, it must have been a mile in. I wasn't warming up. I thought, oh, shit.
We decided to refuel basically every half an hour.
We had Rob, our mate who was on the boat feeding us. Rules were you can't touch the side of the boat because obviously you're relaxing, so you have to tread water.
I hit a problem at mile 4. My arm just went dead. It was killer. I don't know what was wrong with it.
My fingers have stopped working. They're just flapping.
But the pain, was excruciating. I was thinking, right, we're nearly at mile 5, we're nearly halfway there. Thinking, there's no way I'm stopping now.
I'm laughing because if I don't, I'm going to cry. From 8 miles to 10.5 miles, I fucking struggled. I was having water there, it's like World War III. Then I saw all the parked up boats then in the distance. I thought, yep, we're there, we're gonna make it. And then Colin actually said, you're more or less finished. And in my head, I was like, yes.
I can't stand up.
No legs.
Is this what you like when you're old?
I reek. Oh, fucking cold, man.
Only a 250 mile cycle next, lads.
I don't feel too good. I can't fucking speak at the moment.
That's fucking the hardest thing I've ever done. So cold.
It's something else, man.
When we finished the swim, I was done for. Literally, done for.
Job done. Did what we came out here to do, like, you know. So it was happy days, like. Freshen up a bit and back on a bike.
That's the 10.5 mile swim over and done with. Gonna have a nice slap at meal now, a little bit of a rest, and then get on the bikes and start heading south. 250 miles to Chepstow. Not even feeling doing a mile on that fucking bike. But I think when I have a bit of food and a bit of rest, then I'll feel a bit better.
a lot more relaxed now. Just want to get on the road now and get some miles in, like. With these things, always positive. I'll never give up, right? Oh, I need my helmet, don't I? That helps.
Right through the night now, dude. With no lights. Fucking hell. We jumped on the bikes after the swim. I mean, we had a 250-mile bike ride to do, but realistically, that wasn't going to happen in one session. So the aim was to get as many miles in as we could and head south.
We decided to refuel every 20 miles. Did 20 miles, pretty easy. Stopped, had something to eat.
Eat, constantly eating, pasta, get the carbs inside us.
Had something to drink, off we went again. Kept going, we refueled again, and it must have been about 2 o'clock in the morning, and we'd done 80 miles.
We started getting tired, and the weather started getting really shitty, started raining.
We just kind of looked at each other and thought, right, what are we going to do? Are we going to continue in the rain, or are we going to stop and have a kip, and then restart and just do the rest the next day?
I thought we need to pull up somewhere to kip. We didn't want to get our cycle clothes wet, because again, Mr. Prepared here didn't have any more cycle gear, did he? So the last thing I wanted to do was wake up in the morning with wet gear.
Must have been about 6 o'clock in the morning, and I could hear the rain hitting a van. I just thought, oh, stay in bed. Hopefully the rain will go.
We slept at the side of the road, and when you know you're about to do 170 miles on a bike, it's pissing down. It's not a good start to the day. And when I woke up, lo and behold, it was pissing down.
And I was on a bit of a downer then, thinking, oh, bollocks, it's the last thing you need. There's nothing worse than cycling in the wet. You know, I got up, I was cold. I wasn't looking forward to a day of rain.
I hate the rain. I fucking hate the rain. I hate riding in the rain. I hate everything about the rain. I just don't like it.
I thought, well, I need to mess, we've got to get on with it. And off we went again.
Head down, driving rain, the wind, and of course, because you're wet, it was cold.
I'm not on the lake.
We were on B roads, and you know, they're tight roads and they're really dangerous on a bike. It was quite good all the way down, and as soon as we hit Wales mountains, there was this one hill, I think it was near Monmouth Way or something like that. Never ended. Absolutely never ended.
It continued for miles, miles and miles. And I could see that he started having some problems.
I am not a Tour de France rider. It's just, it was just never ended.
As I got next to him, he just fell on the floor.
I was going, and I just fell, just poof, dropped there and then on the fucking road.
The energy was sapped from him. There was nothing left.
That's the point on the whole triathlon, on the bike. I proper started losing my mind. I just didn't know where I was. I was being really weird. Can't really explain it. I just didn't feel myself. It was horrible. Sat in the back of the van. They were trying to bring me around with food and stuff, but I was just losing my mind. It was absolutely going stir crazy. Yeah!
We're both absolutely shattered, but then stoked at the same time that we had arrived at Chepstow. Time to refuel, have a little break before the Redland.
It was really dark, it was late at night. I know myself, I'm doing marathons, you know, it takes a good 4 hours. When you're fit, you know, there's no way I'm going to be doing a marathon in four hours. It's going to take at least 7. At one point I thought, there's no way I'm going to be able to run, even just down the road. But the joys of food kicked in, and we were ready to go again. Running this thing.
Ready, Tig?
Yeah.
Ready?
We ran 6 miles at that point, and I was starting to feel rough. There was nothing there, like I sacked everything out.
How are you feeling, man?
shitty. I didn't carry anything with me. And I haven't had anything for 6 miles, like. And it's just dreamy as all. See things ain't so pretty. Check up
on Lily for the week. Feeling better than what I did when I just the last part of that bike anyway. Yeah. Like, so I can actually speak, so it's gonna be good.
I started to come round a bit. He started printing again, but my brother had second wind. He was gone. He was like, where's he got all that energy from?
Because I had a massive sprint on with the run and I was just, oof, I was going. And I was like, yes, man, yes. And my head was like, I'm going to do this. I'm feeling really good now. That was short-lived. Everything stopped working. The food stopped working. Just started going crazy. It was more or less walk, run, walk, run, walk, run.
Nearly 2 o'clock in the morning, we'd stopped to refuel it. And I was looking at you boys, and I just thought, I was paranoid. My head was fried. And I looked at my brother, I was just thinking, this is mile 16 now, and I just thought, should we call it a day?
We just called it a day. Shook each other's hand. Even though our minds were going just everywhere. After 16 miles, we just called it a day. After a 10.5 mile swim, 250 mile bike, and a 16 mile marathon, we've called it a day.
Legs have turned to lead, basically.
We're fucked. We're not running. Freezing, we're soaked, and that's all we spent all day freezing and soaking. You know where I'm going now? I'm going to fucking bed.
I'll be honest. I'm gutted to a point of not doing what I set out to do, is doing full marathon. But at the same time, the 16 miles is good enough. You know, I'm happy from that point of view.
The whole purpose about this triathlon was obviously to raise money for Tŷ Hafan, and the other purpose was to see how far we could push our bodies before they started breaking down and started going nuts. We completely and utterly achieved what we wanted to do, because that's the first time in my life I've ever witnessed what it was like to push my body that far to where it was more or less swearing at me from the inside to say, well, what are you doing to me? Stop. It's literally, honestly, please stop. You're ruining me. A great life, a cracking life experience.
Just found out that my bell end is red raw. I have problems with my scrotum all the time.
Oh,
I just had a look at it. Oh, it's ruined.
Fuck, I had to take all my clothes off to have a fucking dump, didn't I? Fucking night there.